यन्मायावशवर्ति विश्वमखिलं ब्रह्मादिदेवासुरा यत्सत्त्वादमृषैव भाति सकलं रज्जो यथा हेर्भ्रमः यत्पादप्लवमेकमेव हि भवां बोधे स्थितीर्षावतां वन्देहं तमशेषकारणपरं रामाख्यमीशं हरिम्। हरिओम। इन द लास्ट फ्यू दोहास वी हैड सीन Goswami ji telling us about that name of the Lord is such a powerful sadhana, it can work in any yuga. And we had seen that yuga outside is one, but our mind also goes through different yugas. Sometimes it is very sattvic, sometimes it is rajasic, sometimes it is very tamasic, where no other sadhana can be done. So nama japa is our best support to come out of it. Now the portion that Goswamiji is concluding, the Vandana Prakaranam. So from Doha number 1 until the 29th Doha, the three Dohas of 29th one, until that point is the Vandana Prakaranam. So some beautiful ideas are there, even in the last Doha of this Vandana Prakaranam. Let us chant after 28. Ati badi mori dithai kori. From there we will chant. Shri Ram Jaya Ram Jaya Jaya Rama. 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 Ati badi mori dhithai khori, suni aghanar kahu nakas kori. Samuji saham mohi apadar apane, सो सुधी राम कीन ही नहीं सपने। सुनी अवलोकी सुचित चख चाही, भगति मोरी मति स्वामी सराही। कहतन साई होई ही यनी की, रीझत राम जानी जन जी की। हति न प्रभु चित चूक किए की, करत सुरति सय बारहिए की। जेहि अघ बधे उब्याध जिमि बाली, फिर सुकंठ सोई कीन्हि कुचाली। सोई करतूति विभीषण केरी, सपनि हु सोन राम ही अहेरी। ते भरत ही भेटत सन माने, राजसभा रघुबीर बखाने। प्रभु तरु तर कपिडार पर, पेकिये आपु समान। तुलसी कहून राम से, साहिब सील निधान। राम निकाई रावरी, है सब ही कोनीक। जो यह साची है सदा, तो नीको तुलसी कर। एही विधि निज गुण दोष कही, सब ही बहुरी सिरुनाई। बरनौ रघुबर बिसद जसु, सुनि कलि कलुषन साई। श्रियावर रामचंद्र की जय, पवन सुत हनुमान की जय। उमा
गणपति महादेव की जय। बोलो भाई सब संतन की जय। श्री सद्गुरुनाथ महाराज की जय।
अति बड़ी मोरी डिठाई खोरी, सुनी अगर नर कहू ना कसकोरी। गोस्वामी जी सेज व्हाट टू टॉक अबाउट माय पाप कर्मस, दे आर सो मच दैट इवन आई एम अफ्रेड दैट आई विल नॉट गेट अ प्लेस इन नरक ऑल्सो। समुजी सहम मोहे अपडर अपने, सो सुदे राम कीन नहीं सपने। इवन दो आई हैव दिस फियर इन माई हार्ट दैट यू नो वॉट विल हैपन टू मी बिकॉज ऑफ माई पाप कर्मस, भगवान डिड नॉट पे अटेंशन टू इट इवन इन ड्रीम। Means he never looked at my papa karmas. And this is the sadhana that we had seen earlier also, that becoming dina in front of Bhagwan is a very nice way, very good way of cleansing our mind. Whether we say it verbally, loudly to others, that is not the point. But this is that dialogue with Bhagwan where we accept our weakness, whatever that weakness could be. But we say, Bhagwan, I don't endorse it, but I am seeking your help to overcome it. So that is what is meant by this papa karma, and again Goswamiji praying to Bhagwan. And whenever we do any sadhana, we might have a question. Is this the right thing to do? Am I headed in the right direction? Because this sadhana is something which is very unique to Bhakti Marga. What is that sadhana? Becoming dina in front of Bhagwan. There should be some time during our day where we can have this conversation. Either it is before going to bed or sometime when we are sitting at our altar. This thought should come in our mind that Bhagwan, right now there are too many impurities in the mind. And may you give me the strength to overcome that. And our rishis and mahatmas, they understood that doing this every day might not be feasible. People might forget, or you know, we might find so many other things because of which we might not end up doing this. So they said, at least when we do puja, we will put one mantra so that we get reminded of that fact. In some pujas they chant, you know, papoham, papakarmaham, papatma, papasambhavaha, trahimam. Means, this is the same thought, you know, that seeking Bhagwan's grace, Bhagwan's help in overcoming our weakness. And now how do we know that this is the right sadhana? How do we know that we are headed in the right path with this kind of bhava? So next Chaupayi Goswamiji says, Suni ava loki suchita chaka chahi, bhagati mori mati swami sarahi. This I can say that Goswamiji is saying, that having heard this kind of prayer, Suni ava loki, very keenly watching over my mind and having heard my prayer, Suchita Chakha Chahi, Bhagwan actually gave me that purity of mind. And Bhagati Mori Mati Swami Sarahi, even accepted it. You know, whenever we take something to somebody, when they accept it, we feel very nice and we also know that we have got the right thing for them. So to Bhagwan, when we offer this kind of a prayer, Goswamiji says, the acceptance of Bhagwan of this prayer is in the form of a pure mind. Means Antaryami is seated right in our heart, and whenever the mind becomes lighter, whenever the mind becomes free from inner weakness, or free from agitations, दैट इज अ साइन ऑफ भगवान्स एंडोर्समेंट, अनुमोदनम इट इज कॉल्ड. एंड नाउ यू सी, इन वॉट एवर एक्शंस दैट वी डू, इफ वी हैव धर्म इन इट, दैट एक्शन इट्सेल्फ gives lot of calmness of mind. Means, let us say we ended up helping somebody without any expectations. So just that act gives lot of, you know, joy in the mind. And that joy which we experience in the mind is a sign of Bhagwan's happiness. And this thought cannot come when we have done some kind of adharma. No matter how much we might justify that, it will prick somewhere in our conscience. This is demonstrated or depicted in Dhritarashtra's case. When he sends Pandavas to the forest, on one side he is torn between these words of Vidurji. He has clearly told him what is dharma, what is the right thing to do. And on the other side he has this attachment for his sons. But that night, it is said, you know, Dhritarashtra could not sleep. This is the same thing. You know, how do we know that Bhagwan is happy with us? If our mind is free from agitations, it has done dharmic acts because of which it has become free from agitation, then Bhagwan is also endorsing it. So this kind of sadhana of going to Bhagwan and offering our weaknesses, that Goswamiji says, in his case, that Bhagwan has endorsed it and he has actually seen the result of that sadhana. Kahata nasai hoyi aniki rijhata rama jani jana jiki. And thinking about ourselves in this way, that, you know, we have these weaknesses, he says that itself is a good sadhana. कहत नसाई होई ही नीकी. And this Bhagwan also likes very much. Because he doesn't like, even if let us say somebody is there without any weaknesses, and if that person has this abhimana that I don't have any weakness, that Bhagwan says that is the problem. Having this abhimana, having this ahankara, that is what I want. Next two chaupais are beautiful. They talk about what is Swabhava of Bhagwan Rama. In Bhakti Marga, we have to take one Ishta Devata, whoever it is. And then the way we will get connected with Ishta Devata, with Bhagwan, is through several ways. And one of the way is by knowing their Swabhava. And the prayer is that whatever we dwell upon, whatever we contemplate upon, that automatically becomes our swabhava. It should become our swabhava. And until that point, you know, the sadhaka should keep doing more and more sadhana. Mind has this nature that whatever it dwells on, it takes that form. And this we can very clearly see with our own everyday experience. If we read some news which is agitating, we might say eyes are reading it, but mind is agitated. On the other hand, if you read an inspiring story about somebody, or you hear about somebody's, you know, hardships and how they went through it and overcame those hardships, then that itself gives the mind lot of strength. So here Goswamiji is saying, for a sadhaka or for a devotee, it is very essential that we know what is Swabhava of Bhagwan Rama. First Swabhava, he says, Rahatina Prabhuchita Chuka Kiyeki Karata Surata Saya Bharahiyeki. Bhagwan's Swabhava is such, if somebody has hurt him at any point, somebody has done some mistake, he never remembers that. But on the other hand, if somebody has done something good to him, he never forgets it. Karata surati saya barahi eki. Again and again, he keeps remembering that particular thing that somebody has done good to him. Now, this is a very wonderful swabhava, such an inspiration, you know. And Goswamiji gives examples also. He says, Sugriva, when Bhagwan met him the first time, he said, Vali is the one who is very indulgent, and you know, because of this pride, arrogance, he has thrown me out of the kingdom, everything Sugriva says. And then the, you know, battle happens and Bhagwan finishes Vali. But then he says, now this is monsoon season, before we start going for Sitaji, we will take a break. In monsoon, we cannot search for Sitaji with our full power. Let us wait for some time, let monsoon season be over, then we will start. And Sugriva, he says, you also go back to Kishkinda, you rest for some time and you come back. And it is said, when Sugriva goes back, he commits the same mistake that Vali had committed. Means he also starts becoming indulgent, and whatever things were, you know, about Vali, the same things Sugriva does. But Bhagwan accepts him back. You know, he doesn't remember what mistakes his devotees have done. He is very large hearted. In case of Vibhishan also, that is the second example Goswamiji gives. This is a very, you know, interesting example. We would wonder, what he is saying there is, Vibhishana also did the same mistake as Ravana. But Bhagwan did not pay attention to that mistake. So the closest we can understand is, it is said that when Vibhishana had come for Sharanagati to Bhagwan, that Sharanagati was with some desire. And that desire was the kingdom of Lanka. So even having done that, even having had some shortcoming, Bhagwan does not pay attention to any of those. Means what it is trying to tell us is, developing large heartedness and not sweating over small things. This is a very powerful antidote to overcome bitterness. Wherever we are, right, whichever team we are working with, whichever group we are part of, there will be both kinds of experiences. Sometimes it will be very good experiences, sometimes it will be not so good. And most of the times, they might come from the same people. That is another thing. Bhagwan's creation is such that guna dosha are together. But the point is, what makes us devotee of Bhagwan is to let go of those small things. Let go of chuka, means mistakes. And to remember any of the good things that are done by that person. And especially catching it right before it starts, the mind starts going into this volcano of dosha. If we are able to catch it in the beginning and remind ourselves of the good part, then this mind can be quietened down. But if it has already gone to that extent, then it just keeps on going there over and over again. Okay. So first quality of Bhagwan is, who forgets any mistakes done by his devotees. But if anything good has been done, that he remembers again and again. I remember one incident, you know, when this movie On a Quest was screened the first time. It was done in one theater, you know, very big theater in one place. And I was volunteering, everybody making them seat in their place and then giving them all those tickets and everything. All volunteers only were doing it. And the inaugural program was supposed to start. It was around 20 minutes or delayed for some reason. And one, elderly gentleman, he was sitting in the middle row or middle seat of one of the aisles. And he could not get up. Everything was packed and he was sitting there. And he was really thirsty. So he was looking around and he saw, one of the volunteers. So I was just standing there. He said, "Can you get me some water?" So I got outside, there were some, bottles kept. And I got one bottle. And that person was such that even today when I meet him, he remembers that. Do you remember On a Quest? So we'll start any conversation starting from that point, So that is Bhagwan Swabhava. That if somebody has given something to us, always remembering it over and over again. Okay, so this is one sadhana that Goswamiji is pointing out. Then second Swabhava of Bhagwan is in the 29th Doha. Prabhu taru tara kapi dara para. Te kiya apu samana. Bhagwan is sitting underneath a tree. And his army is such, they are sitting on the tree, means above Bhagwan. And maybe with their tails hanging and everything. So Bhagwan is seated there. And you imagine what must be the sight. Somebody jumping from here to there. And I wonder how their army must have been. Because army means you need discipline, right? You say attention means everybody should stand in attention. But these are Vanar Sena, monkey army. So imagine how their attention would be. But Bhagwan is wonderful. Te kiye apu samana. He never put anybody down. In fact, he brought them up and made them sit with him. This is another beautiful quality that no matter what kind of, different kind of personalities are there, but never to put anybody down. If at all we can contribute, it is like Bhagwan, in trying to bring them up. Tulasi kahuna rama se sahiba sila nidhana. That I say that there is nobody like Bhagwan Rama who has never let gone of anyone. Whoever came in, contact with Bhagwan, they were always uplifted. And this later in Ramayana, some of you must be remembering, when the war is done, everything is done, Bhagwan throws ornaments, when he is going in Pushpaka Vimana. Now these monkeys, they don't know what ornaments are and where to wear which ornament. Necklace or that earring, they feel it is on the hand. Necklace they put somewhere else. Even other abhushanas, Bhagwan says. And they again and again come and ask Bhagwan, "Bhagwan, how is this?" And Bhagwan says, "Very nice. It is perfectly suiting you." So never putting anybody down. Okay, that is second quality of Bhagwan. And then Goswamiji says, "Rama nikai ravari hai sahib ko nik, jo yah saachi hai sada, toni ko tulasika." Bhagwan, your greatness is such that it has benefited everybody. Why should I doubt that it will not benefit me? Because I am included in everybody. As long as I do my part, there is no way, there is no reason why my mind should not become pure. In devotional path, we should always remember that benefiting from devotion or, benefiting from devotion to Bhagwan is direct correlation with how calm our mind has become, how introvert our mind has become. An introvert, always add the word healthy introvertedness. Gurudev's, that healthy word is very, helpful. It is able to withdraw whenever it wants. It is able to engage whenever it wants, not helplessly drawn away outside. More we can think about, what it is, but I will leave it at that. What is an what is the result of devotion to Bhagwan that we should think about? एही विधि निज गुण दोष कहीं सब ही बहुरी सिरुनाई बर नऊ रघुवर बिसद जसु सुनि कलि कलुषन साई. इन दिस वे डूइंग वंदना फ्रॉम दोहा नंबर वन हैविंग शोन गुण दोष इन माई सेल्फ दैट इज इंपॉर्टेंट है निज गुण दोष नॉट इन अदर्स इन माई सेल्फ ओनली हैविंग शोन ऑल ऑफ दीज Now I am going to start Ramcharitmanas. That katha which will remove the impurities of Kali Yuga. So until this point, in this entire Vandana Prakaranam, few things come out. You know, they stand out very clearly. One is Goswamiji's understanding about Vyavaharik world. How precise it is. And how it is not impractical. You know, when we say, see this entire creation as Bhagwan, he says, yes, siya ramamaya sabha jag jani. And within that creation, I also see what is sadhu purusha, what is khala purusha, the good and the bad. I have clear knowledge about them also. And I know what to take and what to let go of, like that Hamsa bird. But in my heart, I know that the substratum is my Bhagwan only. And in different ways, he has explained about different sadhakas. In Mahabharata, different personalities over there. Oh, who is Dasharatha Maharaj? Who is Lakshman ji? Who is Bharat ji? All of that we saw. So it is almost like, you know, the foundation for Ramcharitmanas. And we were very fortunate, we could go, you know, doha by doha, word by word, and we on our own should also reflect upon all these points and see what is the essence of these 29 dohas. How Goswamiji is putting himself down and saying that this composition is Bhagwan's composition. So now Goswamiji begins the introduction to from where this Ramcharitmanas has come. Okay. So I'm seeing whether we can do two or one doha together. We'll do 30th one doha, and then if we have time, we'll go to the next one. जाग बलिक जो कथा सुहाई श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम जाग बलिक जो कथा सुहाई भरद्वाज मुनि बरहि सुनाई कहियउ सोई संवाद बखानी सुनहु सकल सज्जन सुखुमानी शंभु कीन्ह यह चरित सुहावा बहुरी कृपा करियउ महि सुनावा सोई शिव काग भुसुंडी दीना राम भगत अधिकारी चीन्हा तेहि सन जाग बलिक पुनि पावा तिन पुनि भरद्वाज प्रति गावा ते श्रोता बकता समसीला समदर्शी जानहि हरि लीला जानहि तीनि काल निज ज्ञाना करतल गत आमल कसमाना औरौ जे हरि भगत सुजाना कहहि सुनहि समुझहि विधि नाना
मैं पुनि निज गुरसन सुनी कथा सो सुकर खेत समुझ ही नहीं तसे बालपन तब अति रहे उचेत श्रोता बकता ज्ञान निधि कथा राम के गूढ़ किमि समुझ मैं जीव जड़ कलिमल ग्रसित विमूढ़ सियावर राम चंद्र की जय पवन सुत हनुमान की जय उमापति महादेव की जय बोलो भाई सब संतन की जय सद्गुरुनाथ महाराज की जय.
This was going faster than my singing. I was going slower than it. जाग बलिक जो कथा सुहाई भरद्वाज मुनि बरहि सुनाई. रामचरित मानस इज द सेम एज ब्रह्म विद्या. मीन्स इट हैज बीन पास्ड ऑन सिंस टाइम इमेमोरियल बट देर इज अ गुरु परंपरा विच इज देयर. सो गोस्वामी जी इज टेलिंग हाउ डिड दिस कथा रीच टू मी. इट इज नॉट दैट आई कंपोस्ट समथिंग न्यू but there is something that has come from a long tradition of teachers. So the first thing that Goswamiji says here is the teacher of this Ramcharitmanas, of Goswamiji's Ramcharitmanas, the teacher was Yajnavalkya ji and the student was Bharadwaja Rishi. And he says this samvada between both of them is such that whoever hears it they will feel lot of joy in their heart. But they should hear this also with some devotion. And later on he is going to say that first we need some faith to even start moving on this path. Making that resolve that I want to understand Ramcharitmanas. I want to listen to glories of Bhagwan and dwell more in what these leelas are of Bhagwan. So then he says, this was Manaviya Parampara. Manaviya means from one, you know, human being to another. Like how in Guru Parampara we have Pauranik Acharyas and then we have, you know, Acharyas of the recent times. Bhagwan Shankaracharya ji is not Pauranik Acharya. But if we say Ved Vyasji, then Ved Vyasji was in Pauranik times. So here Goswami ji says, although I said Yajnavalkya ji and Bharadwaj ji, they were the teacher-student pair, this Ram Katha has come from none other than Bhagwan Shiva himself. Means it is not composed by any jiva. Just like Brahma Vidya comes from Ishvara himself, Ram Katha also first was composed by Bhagwan himself. And then Bhagwan first gave it to Parvati ji. Later on that story also will come. But Parvati ji did not again, you know, continue teaching or anything. She was content with that Ram Katha. So then Bhagwan Shiva must have thought, you know, this should continue. It should reach further. So what he did was, he taught this Ram Katha to Kakabhusundi ji. Kakabhusundi ji was in the form of a crow. That itself is to show that adhikari of Ramakatha, adhikari of Brahma Vidya, body is only an instrument. What is needed is this desire in our heart to know something more. This discontentment is a very good feeling. If it is channelized in the right direction, right? Understanding limitations of worldly enjoyments, if that limitation is bothering us, it is very good. Because those will become the adhikaris of Ramcharitmanas and also Adhikaris of Brahma Vidya. So this we should always keep in mind. What is said as Atman, Brahman in Upanishad is called in devotional text as Bhagwan Rama and Bhagwan Krishna. According to the text, in Bhagavatam, the main emphasis will be on Bhagwan Krishna. In the Ramcharitmanas, it will be on Bhagwan Rama. So this is the Guru Parampara, he says. You know, starting from Lord Shiva, it was given to Kaka Bhusundi ji. And then Kaka Bhusundi ji taught to Yajnavalkya ji. And like this, it was passed on. And then it came to my teacher. Tehi sana jaga balika puni pava, tina puni bharadvaja prati gava. Yajnavalkya ji taught to Bharadvaj ji. But next line is interesting. Yajnavalkya ji and Bharadvaj ji both were of very high caliber. Te shrota bhakata samasila, samadarsi ja nahi harilila. Both shrota and vakta, they were very, very knowledgeable. That is just to show that how much depth is there in Ramcharitmanas. That even those rishis who knew everything, what kind of knowledge they had? Next he says, Janahi tini nija kala. Janahi tini kala nija jnana. Means they were knowers of all three periods of time. Yoga ja pratyakshat is called. Those who can see into past, future, and now also they have very clear knowledge of everything. Valmiki ji also is given this title, you know, that he knew Trikalajna. Because of their sadhana, because of their tapas, it was so great that they were of that caliber. They were in the parampara of this Ramcharitmanas. Aurav je hari bhagat sujana, kahahi sunahi samujahi vidhi nana. And there are other teachers also who have elaborated on this in several different ways because of its depth. You know, it has so many things hidden in it that different Mahatmas have looked at it in different ways. Then he says, where did I listen to this? Goswamiji is telling, where did I come to hear of this Ramakatha? Mai puni nija gura suna sana suni katha su sukara kheta. In this place called Sukar Khet, Varaha Kshetra, which is somewhere near UP right now. He said, in this place, I heard this Ramakatha from my teacher. But something happened when I heard. Samuji nahi tasi balapana, tab ati rahe hu achet. In spite of this lineage being so great, somebody like Yajnavalkya ji teaching it to Bharadwaj ji, and they were such brilliant teachers. When I was studying, I ended up not paying attention. That is why I could not understand too much. Samuji nahi tasi balapana, because I had other things which were bothering me. Balapana means that. Balastavat krida saktah. Tarunastavat taruni saktah. What Bhagwan said in Bhaja Govindam, that at different stages of life, our priorities become different, because of which even if such a great literature is available, such a great deep knowledge is available, we are not able to benefit fully from it. Shrota bhakta jnana nidhi katha rama ke gudha. You know, the shrota and vakta, the teacher and student of this Ramakatha, both were oceans of knowledge, yet I could not benefit from it. And katha of Ramchandra ji was very deep, but still I could not take a dip in it. Kimi samujho me jeeva jada kalimala grasita vibhunda. How will I understand? Because I had a lot of this Kali Yuga papa in my head. Goswamiji's humility. But this connection goes on to the next चौपाई. वी विल सी, वी कैन चैंट इट नेक्स्ट टाइम. इट सेज तदपि कही गुर बारंबारा, इवन दो आई डिड नॉट पे अटेंशन, इवन इफ आई वॉज डिस्ट्रैक्टेड, माई टीचर टॉट मी अगेन एंड अगेन. समुझही परी कछु मते अनुसारा, एंड देन सम थिंग्स बिकेम क्लियर टू मी, बट स्टिल देर वर लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स विच वर नॉट क्लियर. मीन श्रवणम हैपन्स फर्स्ट, बट आफ्टर दैट देर इज सम हेजीनेस, देर आर द डॉट्स आर नॉट वेरी वेल कनेक्टेड. सो नाउ द स्टूडेंट हैज टू डू मननम. देन हाउ डिड यू डू? ही सेइंग नाउ आई एम डूइंग दैट मननम बाय कंपोजिंग दिस रामचरितमानस. व्हाट आई हैव हर्ड फ्रॉम माय टीचर, दिस रामकथा आई हर्ड, बट आई डिड नॉट पे टू मच अटेंशन देन. लॉट ऑफ डाउट्स वर देयर, थिंग्स वर नॉट क्लियर. सो नाउ आई एम यूजिंग दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी. भाषा बद्ध करबि में सोई, मोरे मन प्रबोध जिमि होई. दिस शुड बी, दिस वी हैड सीन अर्लियर ऑल्सो, वॉट इज द पर्पज ऑफ कंपोजिंग रामचरितमानस एंड वॉट शुड बी अवर पर्पज ऑफ स्टडिंग रामचरितमानस. वी सेइंग आई एम कंपोजिंग दिस भाषा बद्ध करबि में सोई बिकॉज आई माइट बी एबल टू थिंक अपॉन इट, dwell upon it, and then what will happen? I will only benefit. More mana prabodh jimi hoi. That in my mind, what I need for dukkha nivrutti in my life is this clear knowledge. Bodha means knowledge. Prabodha means clear knowledge. More mana prabodh jimi hoi. So this knowledge is what I need, and I feel myself to be very grateful, because of which I am composing this Ramcharitmanas. And not anyhow. Bhasha Baddha means in a very systematic way. You know, when somebody writes a lyrics, we say this is, you know, Swara Baddha kar diya isko, or we say Tala Baddha. Baddha means what? It has been composed not anyhow but with certain discipline. And if we have to discipline our thought, if we have to discipline our thinking, then speech is a good way to discipline that. Sometimes when we have to give a speech, we say, I'm gathering my thoughts, right? What does that mean? Means we are trying to align our speech with our thought. If thoughts are hazy, if thoughts are, you know, mixed up here and there, not connected, that same thought has to express as speech. So it both go hand in hand. With bhasha, with speech, we are able to, you know, do niyamanam of our thoughts. We'll be able to know where there are holes, you know, where we are not able to connect to the next thought, next idea. And in our tradition, this is considered as one of the ways of training the mind. Even when we have a conversation with somebody, right, we should try to track from where we started and where we are right now, you know, going step by step in our thought process. And sometimes we'll realize, how did we arrive here? Where did we start and where did we come? But if we are able to trace back systematically, that means knowledge is thorough. In any field of knowledge, huh? Not only Advaita Vedanta, even in other fields of knowledge, even if somebody is writing a research paper, the sign of a good research paper is that every paragraph is connected. How did you start? What literature review did you do that took you to your next quest, that you wanted an answer to what is not found yet? That is how a paper is laid out. Somebody is writing application for college. There also we see this, right? Systematically, they should be convinced, the person reading it should be convinced that you are putting a very strong case. All in all, what it says is, what we are looking for is clear knowledge. And for that knowledge, you know, we need clear building of concepts and thorough understanding. And this bhasha, if we pay attention to it, that becomes a very helpful means for us to get that kind of knowledge. Okay. Bhasha baddha karabhi me soi, more mana prabhod jahi hoi. What we call in Vedanta as prama. Right? Prama is what we all are looking for, that clear knowledge of nature of the self. How it will come? Through mananam. Mananam precedes shravanam. So all those things Goswamiji has explained here with in his own style, you know, devotional style. Okay, so we'll pause here. Next session we will start from this point. Okay. Now we can do our Nama Sankirtanam.
अगणित गुण गण भूषण रामा आश्रित वत्सल जय जय रामा अयोध्यावासी सीता रामा आपद बांधव जय जय रामा दशरथ नंदन श्री रामा दशमुख मर्दन जय जय रामा कौसल्या सुखवर धन रामा कामित फलदा जय जय रामा पाप विमोचन श्री रामा पट्ठाभिरामा जय जय रामा जानकी वल्लभ सीता रामा जय रघुरामा जय सीतारामा वानर सेवित श्री रामा वारिधि वंदन जय जय रामा हनुमत पूजित सीता रामा श्री राम जय जय रामा रघुपति राघव राजा रामा पतित पावन सीता रामा श्री राम जय जय रामा श्री राम जय जय रामा सियावर रामचंद्र की जय सद्गुरुनाथ महाराज की जय